Hello and welcome to this SpaceClaim tutorial by Futurescape. My name is Ted. I'm an application specialist with Futurescape. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create your own custom drawing template. So what I've done here is I've just created a new drawing sheet for a blank design just get sort of the generic drawing template. So I can go up here to the Format button under the Detail tab, and I can change it to whatever. For example, maybe I want to change it to an A landscape or whatever. These are all sort of the defaults that come with SpaceClaim. But maybe I want to use, you know, my own custom template. And to do that, if I've already created it, I just go to More Formats here, and then I can open it up. And maybe, you know, a client has sent you a template that they've created that they want you to use, so then I can just navigate to it and open it up that way. By default, it's going to go to this Drawing Formats folder under the SpaceClaim Library folders. This is where sort of all the defaults are stored, and we're going to make use of this later to create our own template. But if you have a template already that you want to use, you can just navigate to it using the file browser, just like any old Windows file browser. You can just find it on your system and load it up that way. It doesn't have to be stored in this Drawing Formats folder. So I'm just going to cancel out of that for now. So to create our custom template, what we need to do is we first need to navigate to that folder where we have sort of the default template stored. So I'm just going to bring in that folder here. Again, the Drawing Formats folder under Library, which will be under wherever your SpaceClaim folder is located when SpaceClaim was installed. So I'm going to make a copy of this B landscape, and I'm going to use that sort of to make my custom template. So I'm just going to right click on that and copy and paste it in place. And you might need administrator privileges to do that, to copy it to the Drawing Formats folder. If you don't have admin privileges, that's not a big deal. You can save it wherever you want to. Just copy it, paste it on your desktop or wherever. In this case, I'm just going to copy it because I have those administrative privileges. So now I have my copy, and you'll notice that these template files, they're just scdoc files. They're just a regular old model file. So, you know, they're just created using lines and text are available under the Detail tab and through the Sketch tools in the Design tab. You can use to create lines, whatever. You can even include in your template, you can include 3D models. So I could have, like, maybe I want to start with a sort of a generic model, a block with a hole in it or something like that. If I know that I'm always going to be starting from the same sort of primitives or whatever, I can have sort of a generic model already in that template. There's nothing that prevents me from putting 3D objects in it. It's just that typically, you know, we're just using it as a drawing template. So I'm just going to double click on that scdoc file. It's going to open it up in SpaceClaim just like any other SpaceClaim file, because it is just any other SpaceClaim file. You'll notice when I do that, I get a couple of tabs open up here. So the first one is this B landscape copy, which is just, you know, the model, note without the drawing sheet. And then we have a sheet 1 and a sheet 2. Now sheet 1 is going to be the title sheet, and sheet 2 would be all the sort of subsequent sheets. It doesn't have all the fields and everything that the title sheet has. So if you create a new drawing sheet and use this template, you'll get your title sheet plus every additional sheet will be this sort of generic sheet. We're going to want to make some changes to this and then save it as a new file that we can then use in the future. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in our company logo, and maybe we'll make some changes to some of these fields, make them bigger, smaller, add new fields. So first I'm going to bring in my logo. So I just have over here in Windows Explorer, I have a folder open already where I have my test logo stored. So I'm just going to drag that in directly onto the sheet. Now make sure you drag it onto the sheet and not up into the menu here. It'll open up in a new file. So I'm just going to drag it into the main view screen here, drop it in, and I can place it wherever. Now it's a little bit big, so I'm going to want to resize it. So I'm just going to resize it using these move handles. So I'm just going to hold down Shift and drag on that, and it's going to resize it without changing its aspect ratio. So I'll make it until it can fit sort of in that box down there. So I'm just going to let go. I've got my resized logo. I'm just going to put it in. So I've added my logo, and I could save this out as a new template. I can also make changes, though. Like, for example, maybe I want to move some of these bits around. So maybe I want to grab that. I can just use, again, just using my design tools, I can move stuff around. So I can move that, those lines around. Now it does something a little bit unexpected there, but that's okay. I could also maybe move this line over, I can add new lines. So for example, if I wanted to add sort of a margin at the top or something, I can draw a line just across like that. Now by default, it's going to be this sort of this color. So I'm going to want to change the color. That's easy enough. I just right click on it and change the color to whatever. In this case, black to match the rest of it. So now I've added this extra margin. And as I showed you before, you can also move these lines around. So maybe I wanted to make these fields here a little bit bigger. I can just grab that line and move it up or whatever, like so. I can add text or move the text around, so on and so forth. Something like that. So now that I've made all the changes that I want to make to my template, I'm going to just save it out as a new template. So I'm just going to go File, Save As. And if I could have renamed it earlier and then just saved over it. Now it's not going to let me save into this drawing formats folder because the permissions aren't set. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to copy it to my another drive on my system. So I'm just going to scroll down to one of the other folders here. Just copy it, save it on my desktop. I'll call it B Landscape. I don't know. New. Or call it B-Landscape. Futurescape, I guess, is probably a better name. And then we just save it out, and it's going to save it to my D drive. So now I'm just going to navigate to that drive and be able to use it in the future. So for example, so I'm just going to start a new design here, and want to I'll just make some simple thing, whatever I want. And I'm going to want to, communicate this design, a very intricate design, to someone else. So I'm just going to go File, New, Drawing Sheet. And here I have the three views. But I don't want this. I want my custom drawing sheet. So I'm going to go to the Format and go to More Formats. And then I'm going to navigate to my D drive, where I've stored as B Landscape Futurescape. Just open that up. And now you can see I've got all those changes I made to my drawing sheet, and I'm ready to go. So that's basically it. That's how you create your own custom template and use it in your future designs. So I hope that was helpful. Thank you very much for watching.